गुड मॉर्निंग बाबू सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग।
And I wish a happy day to all of you. Karthik sir, namukku ini participants ni wait cheyanda. Let us begin at 7 itself because some of them work. So we can begin at 7 itself and let the participants join, sir.
Okay, ma'am. I have fun. Okay, ma'am. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Good morning to all the participants. Today we have to start the program. Okay. Before going to the yoga, you have to touch your body. Have to touch the demonstration exercise. Okay. First, you have to do the four rep stretch. Okay. Then slowly you have to downward. Hold in 3 to 5 seconds. Keep it comfortable duration. Then upward. Okay. Turn left side. Then opposite direction. Then stretch your hands. Another hand. Then stretch your biceps muscles in back side. Then another hand. Then stretch your wrist, fingers, upward, then downward, then downward opposite direction. Then another hand wrist. Stretch your hips, chest, stretch your hands up and down, then another hand, then stretch your hips in side view, side. Then bend forward. Then bend backward slowly. Then stretch your legs. Then another leg. Touch your ankles. Then another leg. Then touch your same leg. Elbow backward side. Then another leg. Then touch your wrist ankle. Another leg, then another different leg, then another leg, okay. Today I have to start the Surya Namaskar, same, okay. Before you have to start the yoga class, you have to one of the round questions is for Surya Namaskar. Okay, I have to demonstration step by step. Okay, you have to first you have to prayer position, that is pranamasana position or prayer position. You have to you are breathing inhale slowly. Okay. Then second position is raise the arm pose or Hasta Uttasana. That is slightly you have to your left your hands and your upper body have to slightly backward. Then Fifthly, you have to slightly bend forward position. After that, you have to inhale. In slowly. That is Hasta Padasana. That means Hasta Padasana. The third name. Third step name. Then, slightly, the step four. Slightly, you have to left leg have to backward. That is equestrian pose or Aswa Sanjalasana. The fourth step name is Aswa Sanjalasana or equation step pose. At the time you have to exhale the your breath in slowly. Then step 5 have to Tandasana, normal push-up position, stick up, stick pose. At the time you have to inhale in slowly. Then have to step 6, the 8 parts you have to touch in floor. That is Asta Sanjalasana. Your chin, your chest, your both arms, your knees and your ankles. So the total 8 parts you have to touch in floor. At the time you have to exhale your breath. Then, 7th is Bhujangasana. That is Cobra pose. Another name is Cobra pose. You have to breathe in, inhale in slowly. Then, 8th, V shape position or Adho Mukha Savasana. After that, you have to exhale. In slowly, you are breathing, exhale slowly. Then step 9. Your right leg into forward position. That is Astra Sanjalasana. Same third position. After that, you have to inhale. You are breathing, inhale. Then 10th position. That is bend forward position or Hasta Padasana. You have to exhale your breath. Then, round question is Hasta Uddasana. Rise arm pose or bending your upper body and hands, you have to backward position. After that, you have to inhale. Then, normal prayer position or Pranamasana. You have to exhale the breath. Then one more time, you have to demonstration in slowly. Sorry, first step 1, step 2, step 3, then step 4, then step 5, then step 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, 11, 12. One more time, I have to pass in front view, okay? Step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Okay. So, dear participants, now you have to touch your body, then going to the Surya Namaskar practice now. Okay, I have to demonstration step by step and inhale and exhale the breathe in, I have to explain, okay? So all of you are interested, then you have to stand up position. Okay. The first position name is prayer position or pranamasana position. You have to, all are going to the first position, normal prayer position. You have to breathe in, slowly you have to inhale. So breathe, slowly you have to inhale with your duration of time, with your comfortable time. Then step two, slowly raise your arms in backward movement. Slowly, slowly. Okay. Then exhale your breath in slowly. The name is Hasta Udasana. Or raised arm pose. It's the third name, third step you have to go to the third step. That is standing forward bent position. You have to inhale slowly. The name is Hasta Padasana. Then step four. Slightly your left leg going to backward side with your comfortable stretch. At the time you have to exhale your breathe in slowly. The name is Equation Pose or Aswa Sanjalasana. The fourth step name is Aswa Sanjalasana. Then step 5, have to normal push-ups position or stick pose. The name is Dandasana. At the time you have to breathe inhale in slowly. Okay. Next, step 6, the 8 parts you have to touch in the floor. Your chin, your chest, your both hands, your both the knee, then you have both the angles. The total 8 parts you have to touch. That is name is Astanga Namaskara. At the time you have to exhale in slowly. Then step 7th position, slowly have to, your upper body slowly have to rise. Only out of upper body. Then your forward to face opposite direction. You have to breathe, inhale in slowly. The name is Bhujangasana. That is cobra position. Then step 8. Your total upper body have to, or lower body have to, right? You have to V-shape position. Your face downward. Your face you have to downward in face the floor. The name is Adho Mukha Savasana. Suvasana, Savasana. Then you have to breathe, exhale in slowly. Then step 9. Your right leg to forward position. The left leg, same backward side. At the time, you have to breathe, inhale in slowly. Then step 10, have to stand in forward bent position. You will breathe, exhale. Then step 11, rise down post, touch your upper body and hands you have to slightly bend backward side. After that you have to breathe, inhale in slowly. Then go to the 12th position, the final position, prayer position. So breathe, exhale. Okay. Today, also you have to learn Surya Namaskar in step by step and breathing also. So, with your comfortable time, with you have to free time, you have to practice regularly in step by step. Then you have to quick, step by step in a quick movement. Okay. 5 to 10 times you have to regular practice. You have to learn the step, understand the step wise. Okay. Okay. Then going to the asanas. Today you have to enter the asanas. yesterday and the first day, second day, I have to land the long sitting positions of asanas. Today we are land to the supine position, or we are sleeping the normal sleeping the position type of the asanas. Okay, the normal sleeping positions you have to face your upper, your forehead to face the upper wave. Okay. This position. That is, the name is supine position. Okay. First, we have to land the Artha Pavana Muktasana. The name is Artha Pavana Muktasana. That is oil relieving pose. That is simple and basic supine position of asanas. Okay. Slightly to the right leg to bend first. Then slightly hold your both the hands to the knees to bend the, at the time to bend the your right legs. Then slightly forward your upper body. Then face your forehead to the your right thigh. Then hold your final position. At the time, you have to breathe, inhale in deeply. Then hold your breath. Okay. Then release the breath. Then exhale the breath. Then slowly reverse ada, you have to release the reverse ada. First you have to release the your upper body. Then release your hands. Then release your right leg to arm, first position to arm position. One more time, I have to demonstration in another leg. Okay. Slightly or slowly bend your left leg. Then rise your leg and stretch your leg in backward movement. Then close your both hands to hold your legs or leg. Then rise your upper body slowly. Then going to the arm position, your forehead to face the thigh or your knee. Then breathe, inhale in deeply. Then hold the breath. Then exhale the breath. Then release the reverse order. First, you have to release the your upper body. Then release the both hands. Then reverse side has to. Then normal supine position. Okay, have to inside the muscles. First, you have to choose that any one leg. I have choose the right leg, slightly bend the leg, then slightly I hold the leg in, use my hand, then slightly raise in upper body, and I have to make it to face the in my right thigh or knee. your up and down stretch your flexible in your upper body. If you will try your maximum flexible in your upper body, then hold your final position, then take the breathing in deeply, then hold your breath, then exhale the breath. Then release your sadhana. First that your upper body slowly up to your sadhana group slowly. Then release your both the hands. Then your leg, right leg. Go into the normal supine position. The normal supine position name, another name is the Vishavarasana. Normal supine position. Okay, then second asana is same, but this advanced level. Okay, the same both legs you have to raise at the time. Okay, the name is Pavana Muktasana. Okay, I have to demonstrate. You have to go into the supine position. The name is Savasana. You have to normal sleeping position. You have to go into the position. Name is Savasana, one of the relaxation asanas. Okay. First, you have to raise the bend your right leg. Then left leg, row closely, then both the legs have to slightly raise your abdominal, legs have to closely your abdominal, then both the hands have to close in closely, with your comfortable position. You have to hold this side and this side, you have to use with your comfortable. Then slowly raise your upper body. The final position you have to inhale in deeply. Then hold your breath. Then exhale the breath in deeply. Then release. The reverse order in the particular asana. First, I have to release the, my upper body, then release my hands, then release my both the legs to bending position first, then release my left leg first and right leg. No worry. I got demonstration in side view. First, you have to go to the Savasana, normal sleeping position. Then, slightly bend your right leg. Then, slightly another opposite leg or left leg. You have to slightly bend. Then, both the legs at the time you have to slowly bend in backward movement. I have to touch your abdominal with your flexible of your body, with your comfortable. Then both the hands you have to hold your both the legs with you. Then slightly your upper body to right. Then face your forearms to face the your thighs or knees. Final position after that you have to inhale in deeply. In hold your breath. Then exhale the breath. and release your the particular asana in reverse order. Step one, I have to release my upper body and my hands slowly. Then slowly I have to release the both the legs in bent position first. Then release my left leg first and release my another leg in right leg again. Then go to the normal Savasana position. Then third asana. Already have to two asanas I have to land. The third asana is Supta Bandha Konasana. Recycle bone angle pose. Okay. We have to already the Bandha Konasana is already have to land. The difference of the Bandha Konasana to Supta Bandha Konasana is slightly different. The Bandha Konasana is normal sitting position. The Supta Bandha Konasana is have to sleeping position. Have to your upper body go to backward position. Normal sleeping position. Okay. I have to down position. Have to go into the supine position. First, you have to choose in your right leg to bend forward. Then your left leg to bend backward. Both the legs you have to slightly in right and left side have to bend. So both the angles you have to face the sole. Both the feet you have to sole the face in. In case you have to touch the floor with your angles, your comfortable flexibility. So both the hands you have to place in grounds or floor. Hold the final position. Your breath inhale in deeply. Then hold your breath. Then exhale the breath. Then release the reverse order. Both the legs have to first bending position. Then left leg first have to reverse, release the reverse order. Then slowly have to release the right leg. Then normal Savasana position. Okay. I have to double system in side. We go into the Savasana position or normal sleeping position. Then going to supine position. Then rise your slightly have to bend your right leg. Then another leg, left leg. Then slightly side stretch your both the legs with your comfortable. Okay. After that, you have to both hands you have to floor, touch the floor. Hold your final position. Then breathe, inhale in deeply. Then hold your breath. Then you exhale the breath in deeply. Then release the reverse arm. Just you have to go to normal bending position. Then release the first your left leg. And right leg. And normal Savasana position. You have to stretch you the legs in with your comfortable. Okay. You have to any pains that you slowly have to release the particular asana. Okay. And that is another asana is set to bandhasana. The name is set to bandhasana. The position name is bridge pose. Okay. Normal supine position. Raise your right leg to slowly and left leg. Then raise your hips and your abdomen to raise him slowly. Both the hands you have to place the touch your floor with both the hands. Your shoulder to place the floor. You have to face your forehead in upward. Then hold your final position. Then breathe, inhale in deeply. Then hold the breath. Then exhale the breath and release the reverse arm of the particular asana. But slowly, I have to release my abdominal and buttocks. Then release the left leg. And slowly my right leg, then go to the normal position, Savasana position. I have to be washing on the side. Savasana position, first you have to go into the Savasana, normal Savasana position. Then slightly bend your right leg and your left leg, both hands to place the floor in your palms. Have to face the downward to touch the floor. Then slightly raise your abdomen. See your comfortable flexibility in your body. Have to try. In case any pain or you have feel the pain. Then slowly you have to release the particular asana. Then final position go to hold your the final position. At the time you have to breathe, inhale, then hold your breath, then exhale the breath. Then release the asana in reverse order. First slowly you have to release your abdominal body in reverse order slowly. Then release your left leg. Then again release your right leg, then go to the normal Savasana position. You have to raise your abdomen with your flexibility in your body, with your comfortable. In case you have to feel any pain, then slowly you have to release. Okay. Then another asana is Chandra Parvya Tadasana. Chandra Parvya Tadasana. The name is abdominal twist pose. That is simple and easy position asana, regular asana. Okay. We saw going to the normal supine position. And raise your First your right shoulder, right leg, then another leg, then both close, then slowly you have to place the placing your left side. The both the hands you have to your shoulder line have to in side view. Then your upper body, then your forehead to slightly to see the opposite direction. Your foot, your place you have to face the your legs. You have to slightly have to touch your abdomen. Then breathe, inhale in deeply and hold your breath and exhale the breath in deeply and release the reverse order in a particular asana. First, I have to release my forehead and my chest in upper body. Then, release my both hands in normal position. Then, release my both legs to normal bending position. Then, release my left leg first and my right leg. Then normal Savasana position. Have to demonstrate inside. Then going to the normal Savasana position. Then go to the supine position. Then slightly bend your right leg. Then your left leg slowly bend, then you have to stretch your both legs. You have to in right side to place the right side in both the legs. Both the hands you have to place to your shoulder level. Your palms to face the upper, both the hand palms. Then your forehead to place the left side or the opposite direction your legs in left side. Then you have to inhale in deeply, then hold your breath, then exhale the breath. Then release the reverse order. First, I have to release my forehead and my chest. Then release my hands and release my both the legs to bending normal position. Then release the left leg first and all the way my right leg. Then going to a normal Savasana position, normal sleeping position. Okay. Okay. Today we have to learn 5 asanas. Then going to the pranayama. Today we have to enter the pranayama. Today we have to learn anulama. Anuloma Vilolama. That is alternate nasal breathing position. That same, yesterday I have to learn the Nadi Shuddhi Pranayama, the same, but only one difference to Nadi Shuddhi Pranayama to Anuloma Viloma breathing. Okay, I have to explain. Okay, first you have to inhale your breath, first you have to use the Vishnu Mudra. You have to close your left nostril, then you have to inhale your right nostril. You have to inhale in deeply in your comfortable duration. Then hold your right nostril also. Then hold your breath with your comfortable duration. And release your left leg muscle. Then inhale your left nostril. Then hold your both the nostril. Then exhale the right nostril. You have to exhale the right nostril in your breath. What is the difference of Nadi Shodhana to Anuloma Viloma? That is, Nadi Shodhana Pranayama is you have to inhale the right, then close your right nostril, then immediately have to exhale the left nostril. But the Anuloma Viloma is difference. Have to inhale your right, then hold your breath in both nostrils. You have to close, then hold your breath, then you have to exhale the left nostril. That is the difference of hold your breath in Anuloma Viloma. Okay, that is advanced level of the Anuloma Viloma Pranayama. First you have to learn, then you have to practice regularly in Nadi Shodhana Pranayama, then going to do through the Anuloma Viloma. Okay. But I have to demonstration today. Okay, first you have to use the Vishnu Mudra. Then you have to close your left nostril. There you have to inhale your right nostril in deeply. Then close the both nostril. Then left leg I have to open, sorry, left nostril, then exhale the left nostril. Then inhale the left nostril. Then you hold your breath. Then release the right nostril. That is one repetition. Right to left, then left to right. That is one repetition. You have to continuous lot of repetition you have to follow with your comfortable. You have to 10 to 15 with the VR beginners. So you have to 10 to 15 times you have to inhale your breath. Or duration of the pranayama in continuous, you have to 3 to 5 minutes. What are the benefits you have to? Benefits you have to heart disease problem, digestion problem, also you have to rectify or decrease your blood pressure, your sugar level you have to decrease in Nadi Shodhana Pranayama and Vinodaloma Pranayama. One of the best pranayama in the particular pranayama. Okay. You have to practice now. Okay, going to the meditation now. Okay, today you have to learn the new meditation. Okay, first you have to with your comfortable sitting position. Today you have to use name Padmasana or Padmasana. I have to choose normal long sitting position. Then lightly place my right leg in my left leg, in my left leg to fix the my. Then I have to use the mantra. Then today we have to learn the Om Shanti meditation or Om meditation. Okay, Om meditation. You have to your speaking slowly. Then you have to long duration. You have to speak in the Om meditation. Okay, how to demonstration? First, you go into the sitting position, then close your eyes, then slowly have to tell the name in Om. Release my legs in the water. Sir. You have to speak in slowly, then long duration. I have to speak in Om Shanti. Om to Shanti in slowly, then long duration. You have to speak in pronunciation. Okay. One of the meditation in Om Shanti meditation. You have to feel the relaxation, then you have to feel the your concentration, you have to feel, okay? Lot of the benefits you have to gain the Om Shanti meditation. Your abdominal, you have to raise your breath, then you have to speak the Om Shanti meditation. Okay. Okay, thank you. Today have to 7:50 have to finish the class. Okay. In case you have to any questions.
Any of you have any queries to be answered, you can ask him, or we can wind up the session and we can join tomorrow at 6:55, because a few of the participants said that they have to leave early. That's the reason we are winding up early today.
Thank you, sir.
If any of
okay. Thank you to all. Have a nice day.
Thank you, sir.
Tomorrow,
thank you.
Let's all meet same time, 6:55 a.m. And you can use the same link to join. And I wish all of you a wonderful day.
Thank you, ma'am. Wish you same, sir. Have a wonderful day. Bye, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Karthik, sir.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you, sir.
ഇത് ഞാൻ പണി മുതലെടുത്തതൊക്കെ ചെയ്ത് തന്നിട്ട് നിങ്ങളൊരു നന്ദി പറയണ്ടേ.